What's quaking, people? Character Quake here, coming at you with my reaction to NF's I Just Wanna Know.
Need a little more of the count in your life? You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. You can come hang out in the Discord server. You can listen to the podcast Nerd Base wherever you can find podcasts. I also stream on Twitch every Sunday at noon PST, and I'm even writing an anime-inspired novel, which you can read on Wattpad as the chapters are released. Links to all of this are down in the description. And of course, if you want to support the channel, the best way is to simply like, comment, subscribe if you haven't, and ring the notification bell for more otaku and nerd culture content.
Alright guys, this is the next song on my NF journey. This was recommended also by Voltage through donation. Guys, if you want to recommend a song for me to react to, there's a link down below for donations. A $1 donation gets you a prioritized reaction during one of my live streams, and a $5 donation gets you a dedicated YouTube video just like this one. Remember, every donation is good for a video of up to 10 minutes long. Also down there next to that is a link to my merch store. I've got shirts, shoes, jackets, hats. I have a lot of cool things. Check it out. If you buy something, it supports the channel. I greatly appreciate it. Alright guys, the last thing I listened to was Therapy Session. That song got me more emotional than I anticipated. I knew it was going to be emotional. I didn't know it was going to get me that emotional. I was crying a lot during that song. It was really hitting me really deep. It hit really close to home for me. And I'm just so glad that we have someone like NF in the music industry. I really am. So let's not waste any more time, guys. Let's jump right into I Just Want to Know. Oh, no. Uh-oh. This doesn't look good. Yeah. Only tell you ever call me. Cause when you feel alike. Don't nobody else wanna listen. When's the last time you saw me? You probably don't remember that. Cause that was back when you were different. I don't wanna hear the stories. I'm tired of all the talking, to be honest. I would rather see a different change pass me in the hallway. But she ain't saying a word to me. Maybe all I ever feel is this, and you don't care that you lost me. Okay, all right, this is a relationship song, and this is gonna hit me really, really hard. Come on, NF, don't make me cry 2 days in a row. Okay, you don't care that you lost me, what's wrong with you? I had a picture of you sit. Damn, that's too real for me. I don't really want to go into too deep into explaining why. I don't think I want to. I don't think I need to. I think you get what you get it. I think you guys get it. But man, that's God. I had a picture of you on the dash. Now it's in my closet with the other ones. What'd that kid say? We never met, but I think you know me. You tell me that I never took the time, and then you ain't got the time for me. I feel like NF has been materialized into existence to make me face my demons. That's the whole point of NF. I've hit the nail on the head. I'm living in a simulation, and NF is designed to make me face my demons. That's what it is. Don't you see me?
Yeah. We used to talk like best friends. I remember that. I guess I don't know what happened to us. Now you got me questioning what trust is. You told me you would be there for me, yeah, but you ain't really mean it, did you?
We used to talk like best friends. And I don't know what trust is. You always said that you would die for me. Or you would be there for me, and I don't look. Yeah. This is ridiculously close to home for me. I remember that. I guess I don't know what happened to us. Now you got me questioning what trust is. You told me you would be there for me, yeah, but you ain't really mean it. You told me you would be there for me, but you didn't really mean it. And I just want to touch on this a little bit, because I can totally understand this emotion. It's a horrible feeling, and it's difficult to rationalize, especially when you're like the hopeless romantic type, when you dedicate yourself almost too heavily into another person when it's not reciprocated. And then when you, a lot of times you can have a relationship and it can be awesome at first. It can be great. You guys are doing awesome together. And then eventually something just happens and you just kind of grow apart. And the problem is that you start getting that feeling of like, well, what happened? You said you would always be there for me. You said we'd be together forever. Were you just lying to me? And the thing is, no, most likely they weren't lying to you. At the time they said that, it was a probably a true emotion. They did feel like they were going to be with you forever. They did feel like they would always be there for you. But sometimes it doesn't always work out that way. Sometimes things happen. Sometimes people grow apart. Sometimes there are things that people just can't live with anymore. And it doesn't mean that they were lying the whole time. That's not what that means. But it's easy to not understand, to feel that way, to go to, you try to, when you're hurt that bad, you try to rationalize it. And sometimes rationalizing things isn't kind of the way to go, you know? Who you having fun with? Don't tell me. I don't want to know. Every time I ask, I just feel sick. Man, I didn't think I was going to be attacked today. I don't know who I'm looking at right now, but I know the person I'm looking at is not you. This isn't you. This isn't the you that I fell in love with. This isn't the you that I got together with. Again, that's not really true necessarily. People grow apart. It doesn't mean they were lying to you and trying to trick you the whole time. But it could feel that way initially, you know? Ugh. Oh, every time we talk, it's like I'm talking to a stranger now. God, that's ridiculous. Ridiculous as in, like, it's ridiculous how hard his songs are hitting me really close to the vest right now. Like, the last two songs have hit me extremely close to the chest, almost like they were written for me. And that's kind of scaring me, but like I said, I love that NF is here. I love that we have someone like NF. And like I said, I'm starting to feel like he was designed for me. I don't want to let it play in this chorus too long, YouTube reasons. I'm going to just go ahead and say what I think this symbolism is for the car wreck. So I feel like this is a subconscious admission. How do you conjugate that? This is NF admitting that he feels sort of responsible for what's happening here. So I feel like this is a metaphor for the relationship. So the relationship is them driving in the car, and they were on a long stretch of a highway. So it looks like it was a long trip. They've been in the road for a long time, and it also looks like they may have been possibly arguing in the car. So they get in a trip together. You start on this trip. It's really happy. You're excited to be going where you're going. You get in a car together for hours. You start kind of eating at each other. You start getting irritated. You start getting sort of like mobile cabin fever, and then you start kind of getting at each other's throats, and you start getting pissed, and you start kind of swerving a little bit. He was swerving in the beginning of the video. That's the relationship. The relationship is going on for a while, and now it's not as peachy and as fun as it used to be. Now you're fighting. Now you're getting sick of each other. Now you're arguing, and you're not looking at the road. You're spending a lot of your time arguing with her instead of looking at the road. Well, you lost control. He says, when did we lose control? You lost control. You wrecked. And it looks like she's not okay. So he lost control of the relationship. He wrecked the car, and he lost her. He lost her. He feels like it was something he did. He lost control, and he lost her. So he feels guilty. he's trying to rationalize. Why did you do this? Why did you change? Why did you this? Why did you do all this so that I would lose you? Why would you, why did you do all these things? What did you do to make me lose control and lose you? It's this frantic rationalization after you lost someone that you didn't think you would be able to lose. And this is a powerful visual. I'm kind of glad I watched the music video for this one. And keep in mind, yes, he lost her, and that's what the song's about, losing her. But look how beaten and scarred up he is. He's hurt. He's really hurt. He didn't just lose her and that's it. He is also damaged and scarred from this. He may have permanent scars from this relationship, aka the car wreck. Yeah. Okay, that was a powerful song. That was a very, very powerful song. A lot of the wording he used in that song about the relationship, about, you know, how this isn't who you are, this isn't the person that I met, this isn't the person you used to be. It seems like we're just strangers now. Who were you messing around with? A lot of the terminology and the wording and the phrasing he chose in this song really hit me really hard. And I really think that a lot of people were telling me the music videos have a lot of really powerful messages that kind of add to the songs. I think this one, if I'm interpreting this music video right, I think it really is a powerful message to kind of add to the song. I will still stand by the fact, I'm letting you guys all know, I do typically not like music videos because I like to focus on the music and the lyrics and all that instead of the visual. I feel like it takes a little bit of my attention away. I still feel that. But I did like that this music video really added to, you know, the story. Another thing is a lot of music videos do not. And that's really all seem to, but a lot of music videos are just kind of BS, you know. So, but yes, I'm glad I did this. I'm glad I did this video. It was an awesome video. It was a great song. It was a powerful song, a very emotional song. Guys, if you enjoyed this reaction, like, comment, subscribe if you feel so inclined. Follow me on my social media. Join my Discord. Follow me on Twitch. Everything I do is down in the description. Come hang out. Till next time, guys, I've encountered Chick Quake, and I hope you... have a seismic day.